Thank you so much, Kat. Right now, though, we're heading over to New York. And we know that New York is one of the busiest cities in the world, and with so many people and cultures crammed into one place, it can be quite the challenge to navigate around. Now, Kat and Expresso were guests of Cape Town Tourism to New York, and the only way they were able to survive is to get much-needed advice from one of the locals.
Now, I have to admit, being in New York for the very first time can be quite intimidating and maybe overwhelming. You think of all the tall skyscrapers, 24/7 traffic and people everywhere. So today I thought I'd take the opportunity to learn how to be more New York-ish from a New Yorker. So I'm at the corner of Fifth Avenue and East 23rd Street at the iconic Flatiron building right behind me at the offices of Cheddar.com to speak to Baker Machado, one of the anchors of their TV shows, to learn how to twerk the twerk and walk the walk like a New Yorker.
Broadcasting live every day from the New York Stock Exchange, Cheddar TV is a post-cable network that airs on a variety of online platforms to the whole of the USA. Along with his team, Baker Machado reports on everything from business to politics to entertainment and lifestyle.
So getting to hang out with Baker Machado, one of the anchors on Cheddar TV, really, really cool experience. Thank you so much for allowing us to hang with you.
No, pleasure is all mine. I'm really excited to meet you guys. Excited to be with you guys over in South Africa.
I feel like first thing I need to ask you is how do I say hello in the colloquial New York kind of thing? Because at home, I just say, how's it?
Oh, okay. Well, we like it short here in New York as well. I think New Yorkers would just say, yo, because we're in a rush. We got to get somewhere. We're on the subway. We got to go somewhere. We got to watch television. So, yo, this is how we keep it short and simple.
I'm trying to get like a bit of a crash course on how to be a proper New Yorker. Okay. Firstly, one thing you notice is that New Yorkers are very stylish people. Give me like a crash course on New York style. How do you dress stylishly like a New Yorker? Do you have some tips?
I actually would say I should be taking my style advice from you because you're way more stylish than I am. For us, it's like having more of your cheaper clothes, but having more of them. So that way you have 1,000 times more outfits around here.
Now, having lived here for a year, what was some of the first things that you had to get used to that were very different? Because you were in LA before, that you had to get used to in order to acclimatize and acclimatize yourself to being in New York.
So in Los Angeles, there's no subway system. Here in New York, nobody drives, so you have to use the subway. And it's kind of just being so kind of focused when you're on the subway, you kind of mind your own business. So if like there's a homeless guy peeing next to you on the subway, you just let him do it. Whereas if I was in LA, I'd be like, hello, there's a guy peeing right next to me. But New Yorkers are like, just let it go, just let it go, just keep going.
Let's break it down a bit now in terms of New York lingo. Because, you know, wherever you go in the world, there's the lingua franca. People, you know that that's how they communicate with each other. Give me, let's say, three basic phrases or basic words that you think would be useful for me to know if I had to come around in New York. I'll give you one, for instance, like that we use in South Africa is the word lekker.
Lekker. Lekker?
Lekker means like cool or nice. So like if you want to talk about yesterday's party was so lekker.
I like it. I'm going to actually start using it for all the parties that I'm coming to. That was so lekker.
So can you think of something that I would need to know, kind of like if I'm talking to a New Yorker, kind of like a word that you wouldn't find anywhere else in the world?
So I would say, you know, cheddar. Here's a great example. Okay. Cheddar. A lot of people ask this all the time, like, why did you guys call a network cheddar?
Yeah.
And millennials use cheddar as a form of currency. We're like, how much cheddar do you have? What's that? How, like, man, give me some of that cheddar. But not nearly as cool as lacquer.
But I think I've gotten the lay of the land.
What has been the strangest word you've heard so far here in the United States that maybe I could translate for you?
Words like coffee or boss.
Oh, yes. Coffee for sure. But people think I say it wrong. They would say coffee.
Yeah.
Go get me some coffee.
Yeah.
It's like all the Long Island Jewish people, like my fiance's mother.
I feel like your accent just changed now.
Yeah, she does. And when I see her, I then get into like Long Island Jewish mode where I'm like, hey, how are you? How's the coffee? Who'd you see today? What happened?
But listen, thank you so much for this. And I feel like we definitely have learned a lot about being more New Yorker from you.
Yep. If you're in New York, you have to get a bagel. You got to get coffee. You got to go get pizza. You have to get pizza. This is like the greatest food is in New York City. I swear, it's amazing. I'm sure you guys have amazing stuff. What's the food if I go to Cape Town that I have to be eating?
Chisanyama.
What is that?
That is like barbecue, but just on another level.
Barbecue, like chicken, pork, what is it?
All of the above and more.
And how do you pronounce it?
Chesanyama.
Chesanyam. So if I go to a place here in New York City and I ask for chesanyam, I could totally get it.
And it's gonna be?
It's gonna be probably like something they found in the subway down there.
No, it's gonna be lekker.
It's gonna be lekker. It's gonna be, this entire interview has been lekker.